Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.3, Problem 7. This is Section 5.3, Problem 7. It says Ted won $1 million on a $10 scratch ticket. He will receive his winnings in payments of $50,000 each year over a period of 20 years. How much does the Lottery Commission have to invest now at 10% compounded annually in order to pay Ted? So again, this is a present value of an annuity because it's paying, it's not exactly a salary, but it's like a salary. You can think of it as a salary of $50,000 a year. So the formula for the present value of an annuity is A, that total lump sum, equals P, the regular payments, times some fairly big brackets. And in the numerator of the brackets, we have 1 minus 1 over, in parentheses, 1 plus R over M, close the parentheses, to the M times T power. And in the denominator of the brackets, R over M. So we have to fill it out. A equals P, the regular payment for this problem is $50,000. Times, in the brackets I have 1 minus 1 over 1 plus R over M, so 1 plus R, the rate as a decimal. So the rate is 10%, so as a decimal that's 0.10. You can call it 0.1 if you like, but I like 0.10. Over M, the type of compounding or number of payments per year. Now up until now, most of them have been 12 because we've been doing monthly. But since this is compounded annually and because Ted's granting one payment per year, the value of M is 1. And then raised to an exponent of m times t. Again, m is 1 for the annual compounding and annual payment. T is 20 because the payments are going to be made over 20 years. So the exponent is 1 times 20. And then in the denominator of the brackets, r over m again. So the value of r, again, is 0.10. The rate is a decimal. And the m is 1 because it's annual compounding. And we're making one payment per year. Now, let me start working on the work in parentheses. So I'm going to have A equals 50,000 times some brackets. And in the numerator of the brackets, I will have 1 minus 1 over. So 0.10 over 1 just divides to 0.10. That's easy enough. And you're going to add 1 to it. So in my parentheses, I have 1.10. Close the parentheses. The exponent 1 times 20 is 20. So that's not too bad. And then in the denominator, 0.10 divided by 1 is 0.10. So that gets the problem started. Now, what I need to do is deal with the exponent of 20th power. That 1.10 to the 20th power, I have to work that out. So that's going to give me A equals 50,000 times the brackets. In the numerator of the brackets, I'll have 1 minus 1 over the 1.10 to the 20th power, which is 6.72749999. And in the denominator of the brackets, I still have a 0.10. So in the numerator of the brackets, I have 1 minus a fraction. I want to simplify the fraction. The fraction is 1 over 6.72749999. So let me do that division. When I do, I'm going to have A equals 50,000. Times the brackets. In the brackets, I'll have 1 minus 0.1486436628. And in the denominator of the brackets, 0.10. So in the numerator of the brackets, I have a subtraction to do, 1 minus 0.14864 3628. So let me do that subtraction. So I have A equals 50,000 times the brackets. And the brackets in the numerator will have 0.85135637 2, and in the denominator we'll have 0.10. So I can divide the value in the brackets, the 0.85 something divided by 0.10. It should just pull the decimal over to be 8.5, but I'll just make sure with my calculator, and it does. So I'll have A equals 50,000 times in the brackets. Like I said, it's going to be the same digits, but with the decimal between the 8 and the 5. So it'll be 8.51356372. So to finish the problem, I'll do the 50,000 times the value in the brackets. So it'll be 50,000 times 8.51356372. And the calculator says 425678.186. Now that's the value on my calculator screen. The 186, I'm going to just call it 0.19 or 19 cents. So the answer is 425,678.19. If the Lottery Commission invests this much now, $425,000, a little bit more than $425,000, they'll be able to pay the lottery winner $1 million, but it takes 20 years to pay it off. And the difference between the $425,000 and something and the million comes from the interest that the $425,000 earns over that 20-year period. So after the first payment, it's down to about $375,000. But that $375,000 has a year to earn interest before the next $50,000 comes out. And that'll go on year after year until on the 20th year, there'll be exactly $50,000 left in the account. And that last payment will empty the account completely and leave a balance of zero.